Good evening, students. We are proceeding in our third chapter, that is concerned with the recombinant DNA technology. As we are aware, what is recombinant DNA technology? Recombinant DNA technology is the change in the structure of gene in an organism, in vitro changes. In vitro and in vivo, these are two terms. When we say in vitro, it means outside of the body or artificially. And in vivo means inside the living cell or inside the living organism. So this process is done in vitro. Means taking the change in an organism or changing the genetic constitution of organism is known as recombinant DNA technology, or the we can say the association of two DNAs, DNA of two different organisms, and making the association of that, that is known as recombinant. And what is the use and what are the procedures, what are the methods, techniques, what are the tools required, we will discuss in our this chapter third, that is recombinant DNA technology. First, recombinant was developed by the scientists Stanley Cohen and Herbert Boyer in 1973. For understanding the recombinant DNA technology, for us, two things are very much helpful, that is the structure and function of DNA and RNA molecule. These are the two key tools in this technology, because DNA, what is doing, it forms the genetic constitution of an organism. And as we are aware that DNA is the material which controls all the biological activities of the cell. Whatever activities are happening inside a cell, they are controlled by the DNA. Different type of protein requirement of the cell or of the body is controlled by the DNA, because DNA is the toolkit or the part or the segment of the body which controls entire process of protein formation. And as I have discussed in earlier chapters also, that as we see that proteins, enzymes and hormones, these all are some kind of proteins, because enzymes are, as you know, is the high molecular weight of proteins, and same is with the hormones. They all are of proteinaceous nature. Somewhere they are playing a structural role and somewhere they are playing functional role also. So when we see the structure of a cell, there is need of proteins in the formation of a cell also, and what the functions are performed, what the biological activities that are performed by the help of the enzymes, that is catabolism or anabolism. These are regulated by the enzymes or different type of hormones, and these substances, means enzymes and hormones, they are all of proteinaceous nature. So now we will discuss what are the main tools in recombinant technology. Firstly, I would like to tell what is basically recombinant DNA technology. So first of all, we see what we do here is the manipulation of the gene of our importance. Means we have to associate the DNA of two organisms, that is of our importance or that is of human importance. And the way we do this entire process, that is known as recombinant technology. What are the main tools we require? First is the DNA, desired traits. Name is, or we can say, genes of the our requirement. So what particular function is being performed by the genes? The entire process, as I am telling repeatedly, is controlled by the DNA. So first of all, we see the gene, or we identify the genes that is of our significance, and then we associate the in another organism. Host cell, and how we transfer with the help of the vectors. With the help of vectors, we transfer genes from one organism to another. That is by the help of the vectors. For example, plasmids, cosmids, etc. Okay. Then, by associating the DNA of the host and the DNA of the vector plasmid, we forms recombinant DNA, and that is now transferred in the transformed in host cell. So, and after the transformation, identification, whether that is of our importance or not, or what the process we have performed here is of our need or not, that is the identification. Then we go for the multiplication of the copies. Next step is the multiplication of RDNA. What recombinant we have made, now we are going to multiply it again. This is known as the cloning of the cell, host cell. And next step is the harvesting of the cell. So these are the steps how we perform a recombinant process. With the help of diagram, we are going to see that this is a donor cell, and this is the vector. So first of all, we isolate the DNA. This is the DNA of the host cell, or sorry, donor cell, and here is the DNA of the vector. Now the cleavage is made here. Cleavage is done, means the DNA is cut into the small pieces with the help of the nuclease enzymes. Same with the DNA here. Suppose we are using a plasmid vector. Plasmid is a circular DNA. It's a circular helical structure in a plasmid vector. So we cut the DNA of the donor cell in the pieces. These are the fragments with the help of the nuclease enzyme, and similarly a cut is made in this plasmid also. Okay, and now this is united. This piece is sifted here with the help of the ligase enzyme. It's now RDP, recombinant DNA, formed by the union of the DNA of the donor cell and vector cell. Now this DNA is transferred in the host cell for the further development, and after the transfer in the host cell, this is identified whether the RNA is expressing the characters or the features for that purpose we have selected it, means the identification. And if it's, we find it suitable, then we go for the multiplication of RNA in the host cell. Okay, then again what we do, we are cloning of the RNA, and next step is the, as we have told, is the harvesting, or we can say it's downstream processing. So this is the our last step here, harvesting or downstream processing. This is the last step. So this way we see the process of the recombinant DNA technology, and as we know, it's a very complicated procedure and involves different materials. So we have to see each and every aspect in different way.